Welcome everyone to Introduction to Machine Learning and Data Mining. And this is a very exciting semester because there's more than 400 students of you taking this course. So as you can see, you are a lot of people here. And I think that also reflects how exciting machine learning is and how it's becoming more and more widely applied to all types of problems domain. So welcome to this class, where I really hope that you will learn a lot of machine learning and be even more interested in this amazing field of study and work after taking this course. So you were today to read chapter one of this book. The book is our course note called Introduction to Machine Learning and Data Mining. The book is for free, so I hope you all found it on CampusNet. Make sure you're using version 2 of the book. So the book was updated yesterday, and if you had taken down the book from before that, just make sure from now on that you use version 2 of the book, because there's been some updates to some figures and some minor typos. Nothing really, really important, but still it's nice that you're all operating with the same version. So current version is version 2 of the book, and hopefully there'll be no other changes to the book. But if there are any changes to the book during the course, I'll notify you and you can of course update accordingly. So today you are supposed to read chapter one, and what you are to read each week can be found on the course homepage. So the course homepage, should I write it down so you all have it? It is compute.dtu.dk/courses/02450. And here you will find reading material for every week of this class. So this is actually a very important page. And you will also find problems that you can work on. And there'll be three problems for each week that you can study. And these are actual exam questions. So when you do these problems, you're actually preparing for the multiple choice exam of this course as well. So please read for each week, do the problems each week, and you are really in a good shape for this course, I would say. Exercises will be in building 308. Where we'll have room 101, 109, 117, and 127, and all of the first floor hallway area. And we'll also use building 210, rooms 162 and 168. We are catering for three different programming languages in this course: MATLAB, Python, and R. And later in these lectures, I'll guide you to where you should go according to what programming language you'll be using, because we'll have expert TAs on each of the programming languages that you are using. So according to programming language, that's really what's guiding you to which of these rooms you should go. So the course has this structure. So there'll be two very important slides in this course, and this is one of them because it's really outlining the structure of the course. So you are here in week one, which is the introduction. And then we have the 13 week here of the course structure. So my name is Morten Mørup. I am associate professor at the Section for Cognitive System at DTU Compute. My research domain field is machine learning, and I'm very much applied in neuroimaging these machine learning techniques. So very interested in how the brain actually works and what we can learn from measurements of the brain using machine learning techniques. So that's my research. But I'm working a lot on different machine learning technologies and also using a lot of these tools that you will learn throughout this course. So the course consists of three modules. You'll start next week already on module one, where we'll focus on understanding data. So data, extracting features of data, visualizing the data, understanding data issues, and so on and so forth, data types. So essentially all of module one will be about understanding data. So we'll look at week 2, data and feature extraction, week 3, measures of similarity and summary statistics, and week 4, data visualization and probability. And maybe some of the material covered in these 3 weeks will be sort of familiar to you, but stay tuned and don't despair, because right after we'll go into all the machine learning stuff. But we need to make you ready for all the machine learning, which requires to get a good understanding of what is data. So that is something we'll actually spend quite a bit of time on, 3 weeks here, and it'll end up with you handing in a report. And this report is executed in group of maximally 3 group members. So you should find maximally 3 that you would like to work with in this course, and you'll then work on making these 3 course reports. So project 1 will be due the 3rd of October, so mark that in your calendar, at 1 p.m. The project description is already available on CanvasNet, so you can actually already get started on project 1 if you want. But of course, you don't have all the prerequisites, which will come during the following 3 weeks. Yeah. You'll hand in this report, and then we'll move on to module 2 of this course, which will be focusing on supervised learning. And here we'll look at classification and regression methods. And you'll learn a lot of the usual suspects of machine learning. We'll learn about decision trees and linear regression, overfitting, performance evaluation, nearest neighbor, Bayes, naive Bayes. We'll learn about artificial neural network, bias variance, rich regression, AUC, ensembling methods, multi-class classification, class imbalance issues. So a lot of important things will go into what will become your machine learning toolbox, where we'll keep on adding in tools that you'll be able to use. During the exercises, you'll use software with these tools. During the lectures, you'll get the theoretical understanding. And through the project work and the final exam, you'll demonstrate your hopefully excellent skills acquired through this course in machine learning. So module 2 will end up with a project report as well, handed in the 14th of November. And then we'll go to the final module of this course, which will be on unsupervised learning. And here we'll focus on clustering and density estimation. And again, you'll learn the usual suspects, prominent methods for doing this. That is k-means and hierarchical clustering, mixture models, density estimation, kernel density estimation, and association mining market basket analysis. All these things you will learn in the 3rd part of this course. You will use it on your project 3 that you'll hand in on